Okay, hospital vlog, day five. Oh, it's been one of those mornings, I tell you. I actually had a good sleep last night, but my IV blew. It was leaking, so they had to redo it, and she had a hell of a time, and I still haven't got one in me yet. They're waiting for a while to and maybe get somebody else to put it in me because it's seems to be incredibly hard. It was so good for a while here for a few months for people getting blood out of me or getting IVs into me, and it was so easy. But in the past, it's been hellish nightmare to get an IV into me. Or to get blood out of me, and it looks like it's gone back to the hellish nightmare thing. Of course. Can't have any good luck. That's for damn sure. Yeah. Oh well, that's just the way it goes. Yesterday, I had to have help getting out of the sofa that I'm sitting on. I'm sitting on the sofa here because he just couldn't get up. My legs were just too exhausted to get up. I've got a lot of muscle damage, evidently, from laying on the floor too long. That's really screwed my legs up. And it's that's why I'm getting all this fluid forced into me to try and help that to flush out the damaged tissue and help me get back to normal. But because of it, my legs become exhausted by the end of the day, and it's hard for me to get up on my own. And I couldn't do it. There was no way, right? So, the one nurse tried to help me, and I couldn't do it. And I had already trying it on my own. I fell back in the on the sofa, and it just screwed my back. It still hurts like hell. It really does. And they're giving me Tylenol, of course. And Tylenol's not even close to cutting it, but that's life. Yeah, so they needed a second person to help and a belt. That's too far away. You're not going to really be able to see if I flip the camera. But there's a blue belt with that they can clip on me and use it to haul me up off the chair or sofa, that is. And they had to use that to get me up. So. Then I could, of course, can't get into the bed by myself and all this. This is all leading me to a hellish nightmare scenario in my head where I can't go home at all and I end up in a bloody care home. And y'all know that, well, my long-term viewers anyways, y'all all know that I'd really rather be dead than be in there because I've seen how it is in those places. Mom was in there for almost 2 years in the care home, and it was a nightmare. I just there you don't have any privacy, you don't have any freedoms. It's really, really a hellish nightmare scenario to my way of thinking, and the adjustment would be very hard for me to make. So, yeah, it would just be really, really difficult. Really, really. I really don't want that to happen. I just don't. And it's causing me a lot of anxiety and it's triggered my depression. I'm just really not doing good with that whole situation, so I don't know how long this is going to take to fix it, or if it's going to get fixed. If you ask me, my legs are getting worse. because when I got in here, I could get off to the sofa by myself, even though my legs would be burning by the end of the day. I could get off it myself all day, and I could get into bed by myself, and now I can't. So, you know, it's just not a happy situation, to say the least. Yeah. Yibbers. And the worst thing is, I know I did it to myself, literally, because I drank too much and fell down and I couldn't get up. Total regrets. But what you gonna do? You gotta keep on keeping on, don't you? Uncertain future is a scary thing. I've had an uncertain future many times in my life, and this is the worst of it. I guess my horrific luck through 2023 has going to continue into 2024. I just knew this year was going to be a carbon copy of the last year. More increases in prices of everything. Less money to go around. Yeah. Everything's going to be more difficult and more difficult and more difficult. So, Yibbers, there's no bright future. There's no better days that I can see. There just isn't. Yibbers. Have a good one and keep smiling, even though I really can't smile right now.